Hello and welcome back, my little friends. Obviously, you start off the game without anything. You have none of this stuff. There's no traditions, nothing. You produce a tiny amount of unity and start unlocking these things. It's an ongoing discussion what you should take first. I usually go for discovery first because this gives you, when it's finished, 10% research, which I also have here doubled up with another, with the ascendancy perk according to that, and give a 20% science bonus. That's just what I do. As basically all survey speed, science ship speed, which you need at the start, leader research gain, and stuff like that. Also, research initiative I love. But let's start here. This is for building colonies. Makes building colonies easier. That gives you capital buildings, gives you more unity. The colonies go faster. Starbase influence costs are cheaper, so you can build more starbase to expand your range. Upgrade is reduced, you get more pop on your starting things, and the finishes actually your core sector systems increase. Yeah, it's wonderful for starting up an empire. Domination is war. Well, not so much war as well as like for vassal stuff. You can vassalize people with this thing. You get a governor level cap. I never go with this first because I'm not a warlike person, but it's really good to subjugate people. Your fleet levels pops at least such a count towards your naval capacity, which is kind of nice, and you get more unity for vessels and stuff like that. Any technology that the other party doesn't have receives 20% research bonus, which is kind of neat. Prosperity is money and building speed and stuff like that. Shipyards build speed. Energy output just increases by 5%, which is kind of awesome. That the energy grid produces unity, which gives you obviously more unity to unlock more stuff. Here, the opportunity and dream is kind of the same thing. Building upkeep and service upkeep for 10%. It's 1/10, which is nice. And ship upkeep, and you get a finisher, consumer goods production. Consumer goods used minus 20%, which is awesome. I usually go for my species with conversionalists as well. It's another 15%, which is awesome. But pay just a third less on your upkeep on pop, which is kind of neat. You see it here. Last thing. Harmony is about unrest and things like that. Pop growth speed actually go faster, lifespan increasing, go an active attraction. This is just to get a good unrest is just reduced. You get another wonderful building which produces unity, which is great. Bulwark harmony is you build more stuff, fire rate is increased within borders only though. And you get happiness in percent, which is also awesome, which produces more stuff. This is underrated. Harmony is really underrated. It should take him second or third. And this place where I went, discovery, diplomacy, harmony, expansion, prosperity. No, actually, harmony, prosperity or prosperity, harmony. I cannot remember. Anyway, the fifth one is supremacy. It's just all the war things. More star bases, super builds, their claims, army damage, stuff like that. And this is the last one I need here, by the way. Great game. Then war games. This is federation stuff. A diplomacy win. You can form a federation. Here's another unity building. It's not a good one, but it's enough. Anyway, you form a federation. You get the amount you of the naval capacity you give to the federation is increased. Federal unity, you get unity from all. No, not you get it not from, you get a bonus depending on how much, how many nations are in your wonderful federation. And then obviously the altruism and the finisher is nice as well. Yeah, well, it's not that great. It's just a trust cap. And then we have discovery. And then we have these things I have on here left to do. In this case, I want with the research bonus that I can build habitats, build make construction stuff, make stuff faster, the galactic wonders, and some evolutionary stuff. This one I took for the first time. It makes your planets just bigger, which is kind of nice. What you can basically do is you have three or four. You can do the transcendency stuff. Transcendency stuff. Here we go. With Psy stuff and the Shroud. You can go the evolutionary, the synthetic evolution like become robots. You can have what I did with the modding of your biological species. There are some war things, obviously, just some things that go with special, like this will go very well with like domination. Just level cap and stuff like that, edict stuff. But I don't like these because they are not... They are not just for me. Defender of the Galaxy is not against endgame crosses stuff. I'm actually considering this in this game. World Shaper pretty early on would be nice to make Gaia Worlds. I went for obviously building my own Gaia Worlds because the Wing Worlds are Gaia Worlds. Can do this instead anyway. Colossal Predators with Planet Killer Weapons and Enigmatic Engineering, which I probably will take. Or ship, yeah, our technology is too arcane to other super rare engineer, which is just, I love this. I just love this, and you can just show, which you cannot choose. That's about it. There are many things to just basically make your empire unique, which I love. Anyway, that's that. See you guys next time. Bye-bye.